Status quo bias is our brain's annoying tendency to do nothing, even when changing to a new option would provide more benefit. Hi, I'm Graeme Newell. My speeches and webinars show you how to use the latest brain science insights to make smarter money decisions. Click on subscribe and the bell below to see more of my videos. We all go to restaurants to enjoy exciting new foods, but if you're like me, you find yourself ordering the same meal time after time. Doctors gave patients a choice to stay with their current medication or to switch to an even better one. Status quo bias had more people foregoing the new benefits and sticking with their old drug. What most people don't realize is that new options have two very powerful influencers. Our attention tends to focus on the exciting new possibilities, but it's important to understand that our subconscious brain is simultaneously mourning the loss of the current choice we're about to give up. Our own confident ego has shaped our self-image. Most of us believe we're daring adventurers, that we love the new and exciting. But look at our daily habits and you'll discover nothing could be further from the truth. What's the world's most popular ice cream flavor? Vanilla. So your favorite may have always been strawberry, but that new raspberry swirl sounds amazing. But you and strawberry have had so many good times together, it would be a betrayal to abandon it now. So you stick with strawberry. Why are we so powerfully compelled to stick with disappointing choices? That's because evolution has optimized our brain for basic survival, not for the very different problems of modern day life. Back in caveman times, new things were a real rarity, and trying unproven stuff wasn't just unpleasant, it could be downright deadly. Sampling that new plant might get you poisoned. Changing to an unproven hunting technique might lead to starvation for the entire tribe. So Mother Nature gave our brain a powerful preference to stick with what worked in the past. And evolution simply has not had time to upgrade our brains to deal with the countless choices that are available in today's market-driven economy. But status quo bias does some of its greatest damage in the world of finance. Most people's default investment strategy is to do the exact same thing they did yesterday. So a lot of us sign up for the savings plan at work. Reducing benefit costs is a priority for most businesses. So many times, employers don't pick investments that deliver the best return for employees. Research shows that even when this losing strategy is revealed to employees, a surprising number of workers don't change. Investing is complicated and scary, so our brain is powerfully driven to stick with outdated options. This means that when markets move, our subconscious brain tempts us to make foolhardy or overly conservative choices. Historically low interest rates have kept bond yields low for almost a generation, yet many investors stick with their grandfather's strategy of buying only stocks and bonds. Research shows that investors are less willing to sell a losing stock. Cashing in that loser could get them a big tax break. But status quo bias powerfully coaxes them to avoid the pain of loss and stick with their losers. If you'd like to learn more about how our misguided brain badly overestimates our chances of winning, I've got another video for you. Click on the link right here to see that video now. So how can you avoid falling for status quo bias? Well, here are three tactics. Number one, actively seek out the downside of your current position. We get so comfortable with our current choices that we tend to overlook their faults. Work hard to identify the minuses and the opportunity costs you're missing. Tactic number two, try reversing the decision. Let's say a new job would pay you $10,000 more, but would require a move. Would you take it? Most people would say no, but now try reversing that choice. Let's say you live in another city. Would you pay $10,000 to return to the city where you call home now? Reversing the decision takes status quo bias out of the equation. And the third tactic, control the number of options. Research shows that when we're given a lot of choices, we tend to make worse decisions. Don't consider a zillion options at once. Instead, work to find evidence that eliminates most of the choices. Then make your final choice from a very short list. Right now, I'm working on another video about how cognitive biases tempt us to make bad financial choices. If you'd like to be alerted when that video is completed, just click on my face below to subscribe. And be sure to click that alert bell, too. And I've created tons more videos on how brain science can help you make smarter money choices. Click on this box to see the full playlist. I'm Graeme Newell, and that's Better Decisions Through Brain Science.